1993, id Software unleashed a force that would shake the gaming world unlike anything before it. Doom was released, and with it, the birth of a new generation.
The original Doom was a really significant jump in gaming technology for the time. We were making really big strides almost every single game every year. And Doom was a really significant kind of inflection point for things because all of a sudden the world was vivid enough that normal people could look at a computer game and understand what computer gamers were always excited about. With the new Doom game, we've been able to do what I think is one of the most important things for our game engines here, is we've unified the way all of our surfaces and lights interact. We're able to use the bump mapping technologies on the modern 3D cards to bring about detail into things that we can still run at a very rapid rate. And the step in quality is just breathtaking. We're able to see pores and veins and crevices, and you're able to go ahead and see whether a scientist is having a bad hair day. Now, most of the time, you don't get to see this much detail when you're just gunning down enemies, but occasionally something will happen. You'll turn around and there's a monster right there in your face. You see the slime dripping out of its mouth and blood coming off of it, and it's really taking it to a new level.
The technologies that have followed from the original Doom have brought freedom to the artists who are now able to truly bring their visions to life. Gamers will no longer just play games. They will be immersed in them.
Every generation of technology that John Carmack has created has raised the bar for the industry and really set an example that other programmers have used to follow in creating their next generation of technology. Doom 3 is going to be the exact same thing. It looks awesome, and the universe that we've created is nothing short of just mind-boggling. We are going to redefine what people expect to see in a PC game experience and provide them something that they haven't had an opportunity to experience before.
There's a huge difference between the way we created art back for the old Doom, for the original Doom, and the way we create art now for Doom 3. When you're trying to compare what you're used to seeing or what you saw in the old Doom compared to Doom 3, it's almost like a comic book coming to life. In Doom 3, we're able to create hyper-realistic environments, things that you really would only see before in a movie. When a character passes through the light and the way the light works against the surface and casts a shadow across his own body and casts a shadow on the floor, the type of detail that we're able to achieve with each character begins to feel like you can reach out and actually touch it. It's pretty much the most frighteningly realistic experience that you have inside a game.
In the original Doom, we had a lot of limitations when we were working with the maps. The player couldn't jump. We weren't able to have a room above another room. It was all very simple. The level making experience in Doom 3 is much more complicated than any other title that we've done in the past. As technology's improved, we've had fewer and fewer limitations. And now, with Doom 3, we have the ability to create anything that we want.
As an animator from a film background, I was always taught to try to get inside the characters and kind of get a feel for what they're thinking. And with the new Doom, I felt that I've been able to be a lot more creative here because I get to basically come up with how the characters move and, you know, what the cinematics are and what, you know, what the demons are doing, what the zombies are doing. So it's very cool. People probably won't understand the amount of detail that is in the world and what goes into creating those details. All the textures are actually models. They're not just painted anymore. Everything is modeled very detailed, very high res, and then we'll build the lower res off of that, and with the new John Carmack magic, it adds all the details back in. We're getting to the point where people really enjoy having that ability to create cinematics that, you know, are basically film quality.
When we were presented with the opportunity to work on Doom 3, that was a bandwagon I jumped on, you know, with both feet and kind of rallied and said, yes, that's what we need to make, because the technology was right and the time was right, and I really felt that's what fans wanted. People wanted another Doom game from id.
gamers and press alike embraced Doom as it took them through an uncomfortable journey filled with demons and monsters. A decade later, id Software brings back the title that defined the first-person action shooter and makes it one of the most frightening places to be.
The first time I'd seen Doom and played Doom, it came at a very inopportune time where we were, I just finished the Downward Spiral album, and our keyboard player at the time walked in with the shareware of Doom. That halted any sort of work we were getting done. They put a game out that really catered to my taste. It seemed politically incorrect, and it seemed violent, and it seemed like a game that couldn't have been made by a giant company. It was fun, it was addicting. It really just struck a chord with me, the we don't give a shit attitude. That's one of the things that made it great. When I initially talked to John about the next project he was working on and it ended up being Doom, I think one of the things that excited me about being involved in it was because games today, the technology allows a much more realistic, immersive environment. From a sound perspective, it's infinitely more creative. I'm intrigued about what we will be able to pull off in terms of really getting inside your head and making it an unpleasant place to be.